Hey everybody, Melissa here. Welcome to my channel. I'm so excited you're all here. So I was asked if it's possible to have a combination of portrait and landscape pages within the same Microsoft Word document. And yes, that is possible. And it comes in handy, say if you've got a graph or a chart. If you put it on a portrait page, you may have to shrink it down to where the information is hard to see. To where if it's a landscape page, you can make it bigger and the information is more visible to whoever is looking at your document. So that's what we're going to be doing today, is I'm going to show you how to create a combination of portrait and landscape pages within a Word document. And I can't wait to show you how this works. So let's go ahead and get started. So we have a document here that is 4 pages long and it's all portrait. Now let's just say that we want to take the chart that is on page 2, add it to its own page, and make that page landscape. So what we want to do is we want to put our cursor exactly before this chart, which will be right after the period in the paragraph before. So what we want to do now is we want to go over to Layout, go to Breaks, and we're not doing a page break. We want to go down to Section Breaks and tell it Next Page. Now as you see, it took it off of page 2, it put it on page 3, and then it brought audio and the other ones with it, but we'll deal with that in just a second. So the next thing we want to do is make this page landscape. Go to Orientation, Landscape, okay? Now the next thing we need to do is move audio to the next page because we want this chart to be on a page by itself. Now, you could hit enter, enter, enter here, but I want to show you something. The next page is landscape. And the next page is landscape. So we want to not just move audio, we want to make the pages after this chart page portrait. So what we're going to do is put our cursor right before audio, which means at the end of this chart. You can see it blinking there. We're going to go back up to Layout, Breaks, Next Page, and it moved audio. We're going to go back up to Orientation and go to Portrait. And now if you look, page 1 and 2 are portrait, 3 is landscape, and 4 and 5 is portrait. Now we can go to our chart and we can do whatever we want to do within the margins of that page. Now let me show you one more thing, because I just keep saying and saying put your cursor right before where you want your landscape, because let me show you what happens if it's not in the right place. And I've done this 100 times. So let's say I'm not paying attention and I put it here between the P and the R in produced, okay? Go up to Layout, Breaks, Next Page, Reduced, and the P is up here. So it is going to break exactly where you have your cursor. So make sure your cursor is in the right place before you do any kind of section breaks or you change your page orientation. And there you have it. That's how you create a Microsoft Word document that has both portrait and landscape pages in it. Just keep in mind that your cursor needs to be at the end of the page prior to where you want your landscape to start. For example, if you want page 2 to be landscape, your cursor needs to be at the end of page 1, otherwise it's going to insert a blank page on you. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up. If you'd like to see more content like this in the future, please subscribe to my channel before you go. And if you have any questions, feedback, or ideas for future content, then drop me a comment. And I'll see you in the next tutorial. Until then, thanks so much for watching.